You talked about how you're not supposed to really leave and stuff. What are your kind of, what's your typical day, your responsibilities that you're having to upkeep there?
Well, I'm on a morning shift. So there's sort of, there's two shifts between the two keepers, a morning and an afternoon. So I wake up at, right now we're on daylight savings time. So I wake up at 4. When it's not daylight savings time, I wake up at 3. But yeah, so I wake up at 4. I have to do a weather at 4:30. And then I do another weather at 7:30. And then a third weather at 10:30. And then usually at 1:30, I will meet up with the principal and we'll discuss what we need to do for the day, whether it's landscaping or building something or painting or whatever chores or tasks that need to be done for the day. There's lots of different things that go on that sort of need daily maintenance and whatnot. So.
Right, yeah, because yeah. I mean, there's not only the maintenance of the lighthouse, but also you got all the grounds and your houses and everything. You have to maintain it yourself, right?
Right. Well, each of the sites are actually designated heritage sites. So all the lighthouses in BC are heritage locations, which means you can't just let them fall apart. You can't just let everything grow over. They need to be kept in the same condition as when they were designated heritage sites. So it means there's actually quite a bit of maintenance that needs to be done regularly. The houses always need to have the same look. They need to have the paint needs to look good. The grass needs to be cut and all that kind of thing. So
right.
Yeah, it's a pretty big job actually.
Yeah, man, that's cool. So you probably also aren't allowed to paint it, you know, bright orange or do some major renovations either, huh?
Well, it's essentially it's the same idea as a rental. So if you imagine that you're renting a house, you don't go into a house and you say, well, I don't like this wall. I think I'm just going to knock it down, because
right.
The landlord's going to be like, what the F, right? Like you can't just do that. And it's the same here, because the house is actually owned by the government. It's owned by the crown. Mm-hmm. So you can't just go and renovate like willy nilly and do whatever you want. But that being said, once you're in a permanent spot, you can discuss what you would like to do with the house, with the property management system of the government. Mm-hmm. And they always make sure that the house is kept in fairly good standing and that everything is working well. And if you want to do anything interior wise, then you can discuss things with them and they'll allow for work to be done, or they'll come in and do it themselves.
Oh, okay. Cool. Well, that's good to hear. They're a little flexible, willing to talk about it at least.
Yeah, and they're very good at keeping the places in good order. So if there is anything that ever gets damaged or worn out or whatever, they usually send somebody in pretty quick to make sure that, especially if it's a safety concern, if it's anywhere like that may be dangerous or something, then they'll get to it right away.
Right. Cool. No, that's good. You mentioned that you have to do a weather. What does that mean?
So one of our primary duties as a lighthouse keeper is we need to report our weather to Environment Canada. And we have to do that every 3 hours throughout the day from 4:30 in the morning to 10:30 at night. And so with the two keepers, they separated three weathers in the morning and then four weathers in the afternoon. Mm-hmm. And so what happens is you have to go out, you check the weather, you see how far you can look, you see what the clouds are like, whether it's raining or snowing or just dew out or anything like that, and what the water is like, whether it's there's a lot of wind, whether there's a lot of waves, and then you report that to, we report everything to our base of operations, which for us is in Prince Rupert. They take all the information down and they upload it to Environment Canada, and there are websites that you can go to that you can actually see what our updated weather is. So if you ever want to know what my weather is like at Bull Bluff, you go to this one station and it lists all the weathers for all the lighthouses up to date for every 3 hours of those reports.
Makes sense. And then something, what are your kind of, I guess, responsibilities in regard to like the actual light and lighthouse? Is there a lot of, you know, maintenance that has to be done on that?
Well, it's, I haven't had an opportunity to really go into our light here at Boat Bluff. Boat Bluff is very different from other lighthouses. We don't actually have a tower like you would expect as a lighthouse. We just have a big steel skeletal construction with a light on top of it. So it's not, there's not even a cupola, and our light doesn't turn. So it doesn't flash like typical lighthouses. So when it comes to the maintenance of a lighthouse, there is a lot of automation involved. And so the way it works now with lights is there's a bulb and it's all set up electrical. And a lot of stations are set up using solar. So The solar power powers the batteries. There's a big bank of batteries. The batteries power the bulb. The bulbs are small and low wattage, using the Fresnel lens to, you know, make lights go pretty far.
Right.
And inside the light, there's a bulb, but there's also four more bulbs. So when the one bulb burns out, it automatically will change to another bulb.
Right.
So we have very little that we have to do. You go into the lamp once a year and check to make sure, you know, what bulbs have gone out, replace them, and then reset the thing back to the beginning. And there you go. So the likelihood of a light ever going out is really slim.
Okay.
Hey, thanks for watching this video. This is my dog, Murphy, and these are dog treats. Now I'll give Murphy one of these dog treats, and all you have to do is press the like button. Just press that little like button right down there at the bottom of this video, and this sweet, adorable, cute little puppy gets a treat. All thanks to you. All right, you did it? Okay, I believe you. You said you did it. There you go, Murph. She got that treat because of you. Now, I'll eat one of these treats. And all you have to do is click that subscribe button right there, pointing to it. Just click that subscribe button, subscribe to Curiosityness with me, Travis DeRose. Get lots of good video, and I'll eat this treat. All right, you did that too? That's not very good. Bro, not very good.